This unassuming fungus kills more people than any other mushroom. Eat one of these and your days are numbered. But before you die, you'll first have to suffer for days, if not weeks, as your liver slowly fails and your organs give out. This is the appropriately named Death Cap Mushroom.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. Today we're talking about a super deadly fungus that's invaded almost every corner of the world. Amanita phalloides, otherwise known as death cap mushroom, is a species of highly toxic mushrooms of the Amanitaceae family. And when I say highly toxic, I mean this little not-so-fun guy is responsible for about 90% of mushroom-related deaths in the world. It's kind of inspiring how much death cap mushrooms have managed to grow their kingdom. And just like them, we all have dreams and goals we hope to accomplish. Personally, I want to make more time for myself and spend more time with friends and family. It's always better to have someone by your side, and a therapist can help you create and achieve smart goals, which is why I use BetterHelp, who is sponsoring a portion of today's episode. BetterHelp connects you with licensed therapists who will listen to you and give you professional advice by video chat, phone call, or even text message. Different people have different needs, which is why BetterHelp has 30,000 therapists with a wide range of expertise who can help advise you in all sorts of topics. Getting started is the hardest part, but BetterHelp makes it easier by providing you with a questionnaire to figure out your needs and match you with the right therapist. From then on, you can schedule sessions whenever it's convenient for you. If you think you can benefit from therapy, try BetterHelp by clicking the link in the description or going to betterhelp.com/animalogic. Not only does it help support the channel, but it also gives you 10% off your first month so you can see if therapy helps you. And now, back to one of the deadliest mushrooms in the world.
The fruiting bodies of death caps go through many looks in their short autumnal lifespan. When mature, the caps can range from greenish yellow to brown, all the way to tan or sometimes white. These caps can be as small as 4 centimeters or as large as 16 centimeters and can be round or oval when young and convex or flat as they mature.
Just like humans, young death caps smell really wonderful but get stinkier with age. Those who've eaten them and live to tell the tale say they're actually quite delicious.
It's important to note that they are as toxic as plucky youngins as they are when they're glimmering old daddies. So regardless of their taste or odor, they will kill you the same at any stage of their maturity.
We used to believe that these unassuming mushies were native to every continent but Antarctica. Recently, however, thanks to DNA evidence and some serious botanical sleuthing, we've discovered that death caps are actually native to Europe and the British Isles.
And much like the British, they've invaded and colonized almost every other part of the world. Death caps accomplish this not of their own will, but rather as stowaways in the roots of trees like oaks, birches, and elms that were transplanted from Europe.
In other words, they were unwittingly spread around the planet by the very species they're easily capable of murdering.
Death caps are mycorrhizal, meaning that they have a symbiotic relationship with plant roots. Mycorrhizal mushrooms use their root-like mycelium to tap sugars from the roots of their host tree. But since this is a symbiotic relationship, the mushrooms also give back in the form of nutrients like phosphorus and nitrogen that they pull from the soil. These nutrients can actually make the tree more drought and disease resistant. So that's a win for the mushrooms too.
Okay, so how can a fungus that's so beneficial for one species be deadly to another?
Death caps contain 3 different types of people-killing toxins, the most deadly of the trio being an amatoxin called alpha-amanitin. This powerful toxin most notably causes liver failure, and because it's heat stable, cooking the death cap doesn't make it any less deadly.
And amanitin is seriously twisted. It doesn't start doing its worst on your system until 24 hours after ingestion. 6 to 12 hours after eating a death cap, you'll feel horribly sick to your stomach with nausea and diarrhea. After that, you might start feeling better, thinking the worst is behind you. But this honeymoon period is just the amanitin being absorbed by the lining of your intestines and making its way to your liver.
From 24 hours to 7 days after ingestion, on a molecular level, these toxins scramble the functions of liver cells, which in turn causes the liver to die. In addition to liver failure, you may also experience kidney failure, brain dysfunction, and even death. Quick treatment is essential to save your life. Act too slowly, and within a week, you might just be a goner.
The reason that death cap poisoning is so darn hard to treat is because amanitin is sticky. The patient may be given activated charcoal and IV fluids to try and counteract the effects of amanitin, but once the toxin binds to the liver cells, there's basically no going back. If the patient is stable, a liver transplant may be the only way to save their life.
A compound called solibanin can be used to head off the effects of amanitin, since it binds to the same liver receptors and prevents the amanitin from getting its hooks into the liver cells. Solibanin, however, is only effective when taken before the amanitin has had a chance to bind, which means you'd have to take it before symptoms even set in. That means you'd have to know for sure that you ate a death cap instead of a harmless edible dupe.
Mistaking a death cap mushroom for an edible lookalike is actually what leads to the majority of poisonings every year. As I mentioned, death caps can look very different depending on their stage of their life cycle, making identification hard and causing confusion with other harmless and even delicious species.
Vulvariella vulvaceae, or the paddy straw mushroom, which is cultivated throughout East and South Asia and is used widely in cooking, looks suspiciously like these deadly shrooms. Before their caps erupt, young death caps have a rounded appearance and can also be mistaken for edible puffball mushrooms, which are found in temperate climates around the world. Then, there are several edible mushrooms in the Agaricus genus, which contains culinary favorites like button and field mushrooms that can also be confused with young death caps.
While highly lethal, the death cap isn't the only baddie in its Amanita genus.
Amanita muscaria, otherwise known as fly agaric, fly amanita, or colloquially toadstool, is probably the most recognizable mushroom in the world. Anyone who loves the Super Mario franchise will know this red and white icon. This species is poisonous, and while it has the ability to kill, it rarely does. Unlike death caps, Amanita muscaria attacks the central nervous system, sometimes leading to coma. Luckily, this Amanita species stands out like a sore thumb, so confusing it for another fungus is pretty rare.
There are a few other extra baddie species in the Amanita genus that aren't as easily identified as a red and white speckled toadstool.
These Amanita are commonly referred to as destroying angels due to their ethereal white appearance and potent killing powers. There's Amanita verosa, a European native, Amanita bisporigera, native to Eastern North America, Amanita ocreata, native to Western North America, and the European Amanita verna.
All of these highly deadly fungi have a similar effect as death caps. A single mushroom topper of these destroying angels can end you.
Immature destroying angel mushrooms commonly look a lot like other species that are edible. So, like death caps, accidental poisonings have also been known to happen.
Given all that toxicity, I'm here to assure you that not all Amanitas want you dead. Some are perfectly edible and delicious.
Amanita calyptoderma, otherwise known as cocora or cocoli, looks eerily similar to death caps, but is 100% less deadly. Amanita caesarea, otherwise known as Caesar's mushrooms, are equally delectable.
Then, of course, there is Amanita vaginata, commonly known as the grisette, which is excellent for eating.
Despite the gloomy diagnosis after eating a death cap, there is hope on the horizon for ingesters of this deadly fungi. A new compound that's already been in use in the medical field, an imaging dye called indocyanine green, has been found to block the effects of alpha amanitin.
So far, we have yet to test this compound on humans, but perhaps with more research, we can prevent the estimated 100 deaths a year that death caps are responsible for. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for new videos every week. Bye. This is the sun, this is the light, this is Tasha doing all right.
One more time.
Woo, woo. Uh-oh. That is delicious.
Oh,
I'm about to tell you about some more. A liver transplant may be the only way to save their life.
You said transplant.
I did. Transplant. If the patient is stable, a liver transplant. Transplant.
Transplant.
Some are perfectly edible and delicious.
Which ones? I will not tell you.
You can eat my Amanita vaginata any day.
That last line is not part of the script. Okay. I'm so hungry. I will eat every mushroom in this episode.
There are a few extra baddie species in the Amanita genus that are not so easily identified as a red and white speckled toadstool.
All right, we got it. Move on.